God, what an honor to be in your presence. What a privilege to approach your throne. Thank you for granting us access by the blood of Jesus and even by the Spirit of the living God. We come through the blood, we come by the power of the Spirit to praise you, to worship you, to adore you, to tell of how good you are and how loving and caring you are, O God. For if it were not for you, none of us could be alive, none of us could be here. So we appreciate you for all that you have done for us. And even for allowing us to be here together again, O God, to pray. We are so grateful. We ask that your Spirit will continue ministering to each and every one of us. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and we believe. Amen and amen. Wow, it's such a joy to have you again for our prayer devotion. Thank you for your continued support. Thank you for your continued involvement. Thank you for your continued participation in the prayer devotion. It is not in vain. So we continue looking at the spiritual blessings that we have in Christ. And we continue today with Ephesians chapter number 2, verse number 6 and 7. This is what the Bible says. And God raised us up with Christ. It's a continuation of what God has already done, and part of what God has done, he has made us alive. After making us alive, he has also raised us up with Christ. Verse 5 talked about made us alive with Christ, and now we are hearing today, and God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus, in order that in the coming ages he might show the incomparable riches of his grace, expressed in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. So, apart from being made alive with Christ, the Apostle Paul says another blessing that happened when we gave our life to Jesus. The moment you made your confession to receive Jesus, God made you alive with Christ. Amen? God made you alive with Christ. And actually the Bible says, when we were dead in transgression. So it's a work of grace. There's nothing we did. God, out of his grace, made us alive, made provision for us to be alive through his grace. And then he says, and God raised us up with Christ. So God predestined. He had already foreseen that because Jesus will obey his will, and because Jesus will go to the cross and die for the sins of mankind, God had foreseen the making alive of people in Christ, because people will come to believe in Jesus. So God had already foreseen what would happen. He had already seen the plan unfold. You know, God is all-knowing. There is nothing that he does not know. There is nothing that is hidden from him. He knows the end from the beginning. Very interesting. As we only know the beginning as we go towards the end. But God knows the end from the beginning. So God knows everything. And so God foreknew that Christ would die for us. And then after Christ dies for us, we will believe in Christ at some point in our lives. God found us meandering. God found us wallowing in the mud of sin. God found us being battered by the devil, and he saved us. He foresaw that we'll be saved. He foresaw that we'll be made alive with Christ. He foresaw that we will be raised with Christ and seated with him, because Jesus would die physical death, be buried, rise from the dead, and be seated. So today, physically, Jesus died. Physically, Jesus rose from the dead. Physically, Jesus ascended into heaven and is now seated at the right hand of God in heaven. The Bible says that God has raised us up with Christ and seated us with him. So that's a position that we have in God. By virtue of us receiving Jesus, we have died to sin. We have been raised up into new life. And now we are seated because we are in Christ. Our identity is in Christ. So as Christ is seated physically in heaven, we are also seated because we are in him. The Bible says that our lives are hidden with Christ in God. So we are in Christ. If he's seated in heaven, we are seated with him. As his status is, so is our status. Far above anything. So, Paul talks about we are being raised up with Christ. So our position changes. That in as much as we are on this planet, facing the persecution and the troubles of this world, there is a positionally we are seated with Christ. Physically, we are on this planet, but spiritually, we are seated with Christ. And Paul shows that all this happens in union with Christ, together with Christ, made us alive together, raised us up together, seated us together. It is something that happens in Christ. God sees us in Christ. So when God looks at us, he sees us in Christ. Not us, he sees us in Christ. And so it is good to understand that God has made us to sit together with Christ. That is our position. And so our perspective changes. Because we are seated with Christ, Christ, there is how Christ sees things. There is how Christ interprets issues. That is how we are to interpret them, because we are seated with Christ in the heavenly places. In the heavenly places. So in the mind of God, there is a privilege that we have, a security that we have in him. Seated with Christ, secure in Christ, protected in Christ, covered in Christ, upheld in Christ. That's our position. He made us alive. Not only that, but he seated us up with Christ. That is your position as a believer. So let's pray again that this understanding will sink and we'll start walking as a people who are seated with Christ in the heavenly places, far above. Because where Christ is seated, he is far above all power and all dominion, because he has been exalted to the highest place. It is a place of honor. It is a place of authority. It is a place of significance. So as Christ is, so are we in him. We are at a place of honor, a place of significance. So you cannot walk like an insignificant person. You cannot walk like a miserable person. No, you walk like one who is in Christ. If Christ is seated far above, then we are seated with him. And we can walk in power, and we can walk in authority, and we can walk in dominion, and we can do things for God because we are seated with Christ. Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, it is you who has seated us with Christ. Not only have you made us alive with him, but you have raised us up with him. And you have seated us with him in the heavenly realms. Above all power, above all dominion, above titles, above principalities. Oh, we are grateful That is our present position. That as a believer, Lord, you see us in Christ. And if you see us in Christ, that means you see us above powers. You see us above dominion. You see us above authority. You see us above principalities. You see us above titles that can be given, not only in the present age, but even in the age to come. Because Jesus is seated above that. And as Christ is in the heavenly places, so are we in the Spirit, because we are in Him. So, Father, I pray, change our mindset. Change the way we see things, oh God. Help us to set our minds on things above, where Christ is seated in power. Help us to set our mind, oh God, on where Christ is, on how Christ sees, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. May our minds not be set on earthly things. May our eyes not be fixed on earthly things, oh God, but on the spiritual things, the things that are permanent, the things that endure forever, the things that will never perish, nor fade, nor be stolen, in the mighty name of Jesus. And because, Lord, we are on this planet with our physical bodies, with the understanding that we are seated with Christ in the heavenly places, Lord, I pray then our physical life will change. The way we see things will change. The way we talk will change, oh God. The way we view the world will change, oh God. Help us, help us. Oh, help us. We need your help, oh God. Open our spiritual understanding. Help us to walk in this understanding. Help us to confess this, because it is true. It is true. This is a reality, that you see us in Christ. You see us elevated. You see us uplifted. You see us honored. You see us, oh God. Oh, Father, we are grateful. It is you who has brought it to pass. It is you who has made it to happen. Help us not to see it as otherwise, oh God. You reckon us as exalted. You reckon us as high and lifted. You reckon us as elevated. May we not reckon ourselves any lesser. May we not reckon ourselves any lower. May we not reckon ourselves, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Help us to see ourselves in you. Help us to see ourselves in you. Help us to see ourselves seated with Christ in the heavenly places. Oh God, may our spiritual position determine our physical declarations and determinations. To you be the glory, for it is done. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and we believe. Amen and amen. God made you alive with Christ. God has seated you with Christ in the heavenly places. Your life as a believer should be different. May the Lord bless you. Have a wonderful day.